Welcome class 6. Today we are going to learn how to solve word problems of linear equations. So from exercise 22D, question number 1. A number increased by 17 becomes 54. Find the number. So let's see how to solve it. So here you have to find the number which is increased by 17 and the result obtained is 54. So you have to find that number. So let's say that the number is x. So let the number be x. So over here, if this x is to be increased by 17, that means x plus 17, then it becomes 54. That means it will be equal to 54. So x plus 17 is equal to 54 becomes your required equation. So when you solve it out, this 17 comes towards right hand side. So it becomes minus 17. So x equals 54 minus 17 implies that x is equal to 37. So x value is 37. Therefore, the required number is 37. So this is the answer for and that required number equals to 37. Next is question number 3. 1/4 of a number added to 2/7 of it gives 135. Find the number. So in this case also, we'll assume the number to be as x. So 1/4 means it's a fraction, 1 by 4 of x. 1 by 4 of a number is 1 by 4 of x. And 2/7 means 2 by 7 of it, means of x again, it gives 135. So when you add, okay, you get 135. So this further simplifying becomes x by 4 as 1 by 4 of x means x times 1 x by 4 and 2 times x becomes 2 x by 7 equals 135. So here we find the LCM of 7 and 4 that is equal to 28. So here in the numerator we get 7 times x and 2 times 4 8x equals 135. So 7x plus 8x gives us 15x by 28, which is equal to 135. So now x is equal to 135 cross multiply. 28 goes in the numerator, okay, and 15 comes in the denominator. So 135 into 28 by 15. 15 will cancel 135 9 times. So x is equal to 9 into 28. And when you multiply 9 into 28, the answer is 252. Therefore, the required number is 252. That's the answer. Next, we move on to question number 7. The age of a man is 27 years more than the age of his son. If the sum of their ages is 47 years, find the age of the son and his father. So here, this is a little bit difficult, not that difficult, but compared to the previous questions, this is a little bit slightly difficult. Okay, so solution. Let the son's age be x years. So here, there are two cases. One is the age of the man and the other is the age of the son. So the son's age we consider to be as x years. You can consider the father's age also as x years, whatever is convenient. So over here, I think taking son's age will be more easier. So let's say the son's age is x years. Now, the age of a man is 27 years more than the age of his son. It's mentioned in the question. All right. Therefore, the man's age will be equal to x plus 27 because he is 27 years older. So x plus 27 years will be the age of the man. Alright, now it says the sum of their ages is 47 years. So x is the son's age plus the father's age or the man's age is x plus 27. And when you add these two, you will get 47. Okay, simplifying this, you will get x plus x equals 2x. Plus 27 equals 47. Okay, now taking this 27 towards right hand side, you will get 27 becomes minus 27. Subtracting 47 minus 27, you get 2x equals 20. And x is equal to this 2 goes there as a denominator. So 20 will be divided by 2 as 10 times. So x is equal to 10. Okay, so this means the son's age is x years. So the son's age or the age of the son is 10 years, and the age of the man will be, since it is over here, x plus 27, so putting the value of x as 10, we get 10 plus 27, that is equal to 37 years. So son's age is 10 years and the man's age is 37 years. Alright, so your assignment will be exercise 22D, page number 201, question number 2, 4, 5, 6 and 8. Thank you.